Hello, thanks for checking out What's Up at Fun Factory Hobbies. This is for the week ending Saturday, February 12th, 2022. Not a ton of new stuff in this week. We did get a few new things. This one's been out for a few weeks. We just finally got it. Undaunted Reinforcements. Undaunted is a World War II card-based game. And this is Reinforcements. Adds some new stuff to the game. Works with the existing North Africa, or I don't remember what the other one is. Stalingrad was announced, but will be several months before it comes out, as we understand it. This has been out for years, but again, new to us. Villainous. Disney Villainous. The worst takes it all. Gets a lot of good buzz. I've got a couple friends that really love this game. Which villain are you? In this epic contest of sinister power, take on the role of Disney villain and strive to achieve your own devious objective. Discover your character's unique abilities and winning strategy while dealing with twists of fate to thwart your opponent's schemes. Find out who will triumph over the forces of good and win it all. Cool little pawns there. And an expansion for Disney Villainous. Perfectly Wretched. I don't know if you can see that down there. Standalone game or mixed with other villains. Speaking of licensed stuff, I don't know how long this one's been out. Harry Potter Pictopia, the ultimate picture trivia family game. So it's World of Harry Potter, but includes Fantastic Beasts, which of course is in that same world. 1,000 questions featuring your favorite movie scenes. So if you like picture games. Which three of these patronesses belong to members of Dumbledore's army? Which one of these modes of transportation is reserved for your Hogwarts students? Cool stuff. So Pictopia, Harry Potter themed. From our friends at Ravenburger. They make good stuff. And of course, Games Workshop puts out new stuff all the time. This is the latest big box, Warhammer 40,000. Eldritch Omens, we have the Eldari, a.k.a. Eldar, versus Chaos Marines, Chaos Space Marines, A Desperate War on a Doomed World. So this big box, lots of cool stuff in it there. Includes 16 Citadel miniatures, a 32-page Eldritch Omens booklet, Craft Worlds and Chaos Space Marines transfer sheets. Those two big guys. Cool stuff. Swift and Savage battle erupts on the warp-cursed world of Death as Autark Galen leads the warriors of Samhain against the Black Legionnaires of Warpsmith Devok, the Unmaker. Deep within the war-torn Nakmund Gauntlet, these two warbands clash over a mighty prize of souls and a dread technology that could bring damnation down upon an entire race. With the jaws of a warp storm swiftly closing about them, and the stakes impossibly high, desperate measures and terrible sacrifices will be required to achieve victory. And, of course, this is pre-release weekend for not only Magic the Gathering Kamigawa Niwa Dynasty. In fact, we have a pre-release tournament running as I record this, and another one scheduled for 6 p.m. tonight. But it is also pre-release starting weekend for Pokemon Sword and Shield Brilliant Stars. The Kamigawa Neon Dynasty, we have the pre-release kits that you can come and, of course, play in the pre-release events. The last one, again, is scheduled for 6 p.m. on today, Saturday the 12th. Or you can do pre-release at home. We will also be running a sealed tournament with, most likely with more pre-release kits this coming Friday, the 18th, for the actual launch of Kamigawa Neon Dynasty. We should have pre-release kits available still for that pre-release, but you can do pre-release at home. We also have draft booster boxes, and presently have one set booster box remaining that we can sell during pre-release week. We can only sell sealed boxes during pre-release week, or again, the pre-release take-home kits. For Pokemon Brilliant Stars, the pre-release goes from today, the 12th, through, technically it goes through the Sunday the 20th, however we're closed on Sundays, for effectively it goes through the 19th for us. We are having a limit of 2 Brilliant Stars pre-release take-home kits per person physically present, because we want to spread the love and we have a very limited supply of them. In fact, we're half sold through them already, and it's only, we've only been selling them for a couple hours. So yeah. So yeah, that's what's going on. Thanks for checking out what's up at Fun Factory Hobbies, and we'll see you again next time. Ciao.